This is TWiT.
You've had quite a ride through the tech industry. Our audience loves to hear a little bit about origin stories. Can you maybe take us on a quick short journey through your career in tech?
Sure. Yeah, I've done many startups in the Bay Area, and now I'm in Austin for the last about 7 years, 8 years. But the last 10 years have been pretty crazy. You think about what's been going on with tech in the developer landscape. You know, 10 years ago, I was at a startup called Nlayers. Nlayers was acquired by EMC, and we really focused on the virtualization journey, physical to virtual. Developers back in that time were really focusing on agile technologies. The apps were interior architectures. Virtualization was really where the infrastructure was, and focused a lot on private cloud. And private cloud was the major theme, and helping customers move from the physical to virtual world. There was a lot of focus around server consolidation, and the developer community was slowly starting to pick up this new set of cultural techniques called DevOps. Around 2010, I joined a startup out here called Copper Egg. Copper Egg really focused on monitoring, doing application performance monitoring, do DevOps monitoring. DevOps started really opening up the opportunity for developers to automate the CI/CD cycle, how they deploy code. Infrastructure as a code became huge. Things like Puppet and Chef were the tools of the trade maybe 6-7 years ago. And a major shift to the public cloud took place. And we saw all these application providers and developers really flowing into the public cloud. Copper Egg was acquired in 2013, so it was an acquisition. My co-founders and I started looking at what was next, and suddenly, you saw some emergence around 2013, 2014 around containers. Docker was coming into play. They had just moved from dot cloud, PaaS services to Docker itself, and begun to sort of pivot into this whole new world around containers. And that really wasn't that long ago. This is around 2014. We started a company called Stack Engine, and really realized that containers were the killer app for DevOps. It's the artifact that helps you move from development through test, through staging, out to production. The same artifact can move through that process. So it really tied together DevOps. And so DevOps and containers became kind of this nice 1-2 punch. We saw Docker starting to standardize containers. My company, Stack Engine, started focusing on how do you orchestrate and manage and do container management around whole application infrastructure. We got acquired by Oracle, .. That was about 3 years ago. And since then, we've seen the CNCF come in, the Cloud Native Computing Foundation, really taking Docker into the next level in those containers technologies to Kubernetes, creating a whole kind of platform now for container applications. So you think about DevOps, you think about open source, cloud native, you think about public cloud and that infrastructure, you kind of this now this triad of capabilities have been built on top of each other over the last 10 years, really putting all this power into the development community. Super exciting to be part of this kind of this new world where we're now harnessing container technology, open source environments, doing this on a high power public cloud and unleashing creativity across developers. There's so much innovation that's going on right now. So that's really where we started and kind of where the world is today. And it's been an amazing run over just for developers in the last 10 years.